Hey guys, welcome back to my channel SKM Tutorials Hub. In the previous video of number system series, you got a brief introduction about different types of number system. I will put the link of that video in the description box. And in today's video, I will show you how to convert numbers from different number system into decimal number system with the help of examples. But before going to the topic, if you are new on this channel, then hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for the latest updates. Firstly, I will start with the most commonly used number systems like binary, octal and hexadecimal number system. And then at the end, I will show you how to convert a number from in-base number system to decimal number system. Let's move to the first type of conversion, that is from binary to decimal. In the first example, I have taken the binary number 1011 and we have to convert this number into decimal number system, that is base 10. At first, we have to write down the given number. Then, we have to write down the position value of each digit starting from 0 from the right end of the number. Now the next step is, we have to multiply each digit with 2 to the power the position value. The reason we are multiplying with the power of 2 is that the given number is in binary, which means base 2. Here the first digit we have is 1, so we write here 1, then multiply it with 2, and as you can see, the position value is 3, so 2 to the power 3. Like this, you have to multiply the remaining digits with 2 to the power their respective position values. And then finally, we have to add all the products to get the result. The result we have got is 11, which is the decimal form of the given binary number. Let's take another example. Here I have taken the binary number 101011. First, I will write the given binary number. Now, I will put the position value of each digit starting from the right end of the number. Then, we have to multiply each digit with 2 to the power their respective position value. After adding the products, we got the result 43, which is the decimal form of the given binary number. In the previous two examples, we worked with numbers having the integer part only. Now, let's see an example with the fractional part. So, I have taken the binary number 0.101. We don't have to calculate the integer part, as the integer part is 0 and 0 multiplied by anything is 0. So, we have to only calculate the fractional part. Now, I will write down the given binary number. In case of fractional number, the position value after the decimal point starts from minus 1 and decreases towards the right end of the number.
Then the remaining process is same. We have to multiply each digit with 2 to the power their respective position value. And after adding the products, we got the result 0.625, which is the decimal form of the given binary number. Now, let's see another example with a number having both integer and fractional part. Here, I have taken the binary number 101.11. First, I will write the given binary number. Then, I will write down the position value of the digits for both integer and fractional part. Then, we have to multiply each digit with 2 to the power their respective position value. And after adding the products, we got the result 5.75, which is the decimal form of the given binary number. Now, let's move to the next type of conversion, that is from octal to decimal. Here I have taken the octal number 347. First, I will write down the given octal number and then put the position values of each digit starting from the right. Since we are converting from octal number system, that is base 8, so we have to multiply each digit with 8 to the power their respective position value. After adding the products, we got the result 231, which is the decimal form of the given octal number. Now, let's see another example with a number having both integer and fractional part. Here I have taken the octal number 412.24. First, I will write down the given octal number. Then, I will write down the position value of the digits for both integer and fractional part. Then, I will multiply each digit with 8 to the power their respective position value. Thank you. After adding the products, we got the result 266.3125, which is the decimal form of the given octal number. Let's move to the next type of conversion, that is from hexadecimal to decimal. Here I have taken a hexadecimal number 6BA. First, I will write down the given hexadecimal number. Now, I will put the position value of each digit starting from the right end of the number. As we are converting from hexadecimal number system, that is base 16, so we have to multiply each digit with 16 to the power their respective position value. In the previous video, I have already said that in hexadecimal number system, A denotes 10 and B denotes 11. So, at the time of calculation, we will use 10 and 11 in place of A and B respectively. After adding the products, we got the result 1722, which is the decimal form of the given hexadecimal number. Now, let's see another example with a number having both integer and fractional part. Here I have taken the hexadecimal number 84.C. First, I will write down the given hexadecimal number. Then, I will write down the position value of the digits for both integer and fractional part. And then, we have to multiply each digit with 16 to the power their respective position value. As we know, in hexadecimal number system, A means 10 and C means 12. So, we will replace the values A and C with 10 and 12 respectively. After adding the products, we got the result 2212.75, which is the decimal form of the given hexadecimal number. From all these examples, now we can generalize the process of converting a number from any base to decimal number system. Let us say a number is there in R base whose digits are an-1, an-2 up to a0, point a-1, a-2 up to a-m. To convert this number into decimal number system, the formula is given on the screen. Let's take an example. Suppose we have the number 243 in base 5. And we have to convert it into decimal number system. So the process is same, the The only difference will be, as the given number is in base 5, we have to multiply each digit with the power of 5. After adding the products, we get the result 73, which is the decimal form of the given number. That's all for this video. I hope you have understood how to convert a number from any base to decimal number system. In the next video, I will show you how to convert a number from decimal number system to the other bases. If you find this video informative, make sure you like the video and share with others. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.